Hello everyone, welcome to the fifth video for life processes, and in this video we will continue our description for respiration. And we have already discussed about the life process, that is respiration, means the significance of the respiration. In this, the food is oxidized and the energy is released, which is stored in the form of ATP, and that energy is utilized for various life processes, various functions of the body. And the types of respiration in terms of aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration, and the respiration in plants. So you can see the detailed account of these points in the fourth and third video of life processes, and you will get the URLs in the description of this video only. So for the introductory part, here need not to mention that what is respiration. It is nothing but the oxidation of food so that energy gets released, and that energy it gets utilized for various functions of the body. And in the same process, CO2, it is formed as the waste product, which gets eliminated through the same path by which the oxygen is inhaled, and this is the reason the exhalation of the CO2 takes place. Respiration is an essential life process because here the energy is released through it, that is why, and it includes the breathing as well as the oxidation of food. Now when we talk about the respiration in animals, right, so you know that the animals, they are having a variety of body organization, from unicellular to multicellular, and same as for the respiratory structures. First of all, I would like to mention a point here, that if anyone asks you what is the definition of respiration in one line, so you can say that respiration is nothing but the exchange of gases. So the exchange of gases, it takes place through various structures, and it depends upon the complexity of the organism, like amoeba. It is having, when we talk about the amoeba, unicellular organism it is, so the cell membrane, it is sufficient for the diffusion of the gases. As far as the aquatic organisms, they are considered, the gills are there for the respiration. Exchange takes place at the level of gills. In terrestrial organisms who live on land, the lungs are the respiratory structures. We will see the lungs and the mechanism of respiration in detail in the upcoming discussion of ours. The insects, they are having tiny holes in terms of spiracle, right? So tiny holes are also there, and the tracheal tubes are there for the respiration. So these are the respiratory structures. In terms of spiracles and tracheal tubes, these are the respiratory structures in insects. Lungs, they are respiratory structures in terrestrial organisms who live on land. Gills are the respiratory structures for aquatic organism, right? And the unicellular organisms, or the organisms who are having the lower grade of body organization, the simple body organization, they are having the membrane itself, body wall you can say, where the exchange of gases takes place through diffusion. I can give you one more example for earthworm. In earthworm, the respiration takes place through the moist skin, right? So this is the point here. Actually, the respiratory structures, actually the diffusion of gases, the exchange of gases, it depends upon the habit and habitat of the organism and also the grade of body organization. Now, one point I would like to mention here, that despite of having the variety in the respiratory structures, all the respiratory structures, they are having some point in common, and the common points are that all the respiratory structures, they should have the large surface area. Right now we are discussing about the important points which are shared and which should be shared by all the respiratory structures. They should have large surface area. Why? For better diffusion, right? To get enough oxygen. All the respiratory structures should have large surface area. All the respiratory structures should have thin walls for easy exchange of gases. And all the respiratory structures should have a rich blood supply. For the transport of gases. So guys, these three points, they are the common points which are shared by all the respiratory structures, and any efficient respiratory structure should have these three points for better exchange of gases, for better respiration, despite of having the variety of respiratory structures in variety of organism according to habit and habitat, right? You know, aquatic organisms, they are having gills, the terrestrial organisms, they are having lungs, right? The insects, they are having spiracles, and the tracheal tubes, and the some of the organisms, they just use their body wall. The amoeba, here the cell membrane itself is sufficient for the diffusion of gases. So likewise, the structures are present. Now come to the mechanism, like when we used to say that in the human beings, right now we are discussing about the mechanism of breathing in and breathing out. That should be understood to you, because after that you will be able to understand how the air comes in and it gets utilized for the oxidation of the food. So that mechanism should be understood to you. Now the point is that, you know, that lungs, they are the principal respiratory organs. These lungs, right? These are present where? These are present in the chest cavity. And lungs are enclosed in the ribs, or you can say rib cage. They are enclosed in the rib cage. These are the ribs provided with the muscles. So inside the rib cage, the lungs are protected, and this sheet, that is a muscular sheet which is called as diaphragm. In between the ribs, muscles are there, and in between the ribs, muscles are there, and the diaphragm is itself a muscular structure which is present at the base of the rib cage, and it actually separate the thoracic cavity with abdominal cavity. Thoracic cavity means the chest cavity in which the lungs are present in the rib cage. So this is the setup, actually the anatomical setup. Now the point that when we breathe in air, the air is drawn in, then the contraction of the muscles takes place. Which muscles? Which are present in between the ribs, right? And also the contraction of the diaphragm takes place. So this point should be understood to you, that when we breathe in, then what happened? The air, it is drawn in, so the contraction of the muscles takes place. Which muscles? Which are present in between the ribs, and also the diaphragm is contracted, so that the movement of the rib cage, it is like the movement, it is upwards and outwards, like this, upwards move and outwards, ribs are raised here, right? So the movement is like upwards and outwards, and the cavity, it gets expanded. This is the case of the breathe in, where the air, it is drawn in. So the movement, it is like upwards and outwards of the rib cage, so that the cavity expanded and air comes inside the lungs. When we breathe out, this is the case of breathe out, the reverse phenomena takes place. Breathe out me, in case of breathe out, what happened? That when we breathe out, then what happens? The reverse phenomena takes place, where the relaxation of the muscles takes place. Relaxation of muscles and relaxation of diaphragm. So, which muscles? Which are present in between the ribs. So, when the relaxation takes place, the movement is like inwards and downwards. The movement of rib cage, it is inwards and downwards, and so that the cavity gets contracted. So this actually happens at the time of breathe in and breathe out. Guys, you should be clear with that. It is the movement of the rib cage which is there for the expansion of the cavity inside, and it is the movement of the rib cage which is there for the contraction of the cavity, and the ribs are provided the muscles, right? The ribs are provided with the muscles, and also the diaphragm, it is a muscular sheet. So the contraction and relaxation of the muscles as well as the diaphragm, it is responsible for the expansion and the contraction of the cavity. When the cavity gets expanded, the air moves in, the cavity gets contracted, the air moves out. Which air? Which is rich in CO2. The air which moves out, that is rich in CO2, and the air which moves in, that is rich in O2. So this is the whole mechanism which is there at the time of breathe in and breathe out, the contraction and relaxation, and that actually controls the cavity inside. Here you can see, when the movement is upwards and downwards. The movement of rib cage, actually, when it is upwards and downwards at the time of the contraction of the muscles and the contraction of the diaphragm, and here it resulted in the expansion here, right? Cavity expanded. And when the relaxation of muscles and the relaxation of diaphragm takes place, so that the movement of the rib cage, it is inwards and downwards, and then the lungs, they returns to their original volume, or the expanded cavity, it gets contracted, you can say, so that the air expelled out. So this is the exact mechanism behind. And let us come to the next topic of ours, that is respiratory structure. As I have already mentioned, like in the very beginning of the discussion of ours, I mentioned that we are having organ system grade of organization, right? And organ system grade of organization, where for a particular work the whole system is there, and in the system organs, they work in a coordinated manner. Like suppose here we are discussing about the respiratory system. So the respiratory system, it is having the different structures, and they work in a coordinated manner to do the particular work, that is respiration. So this is the point here. Now, one more point I would like to clear here, that, you know, in the simple organisms, like here where the body organization is simple, or in case of lower organisms, diffusion can meet out the requirement for respiration, right? Diffusion of gases. Diffusion of gases, it meet out the requirement of respiration. Diffusion of which gases? Oxygen and carbon dioxide. That is what the respiration is. But here, when we talk about the human beings, right, we are having the complex body organization, and that is why the diffusion alone cannot meet out the requirements for the provision of oxygen, and this is the reason we are provided with the blood, so that, you know, blood is having a respiratory pigment that is called as hemoglobin, and it combines with oxygen to form oxyhemoglobin, and that is how the oxygen is carried inside our body. Now let us come to the respiratory structure. And respiratory structure, here we are provided with the nasal passage, started from the nostrils. So the nostrils, you can consider, after that nasal passage, here the pharynx, right? And after that, air enters into the trachea. This is the windpipe, you can say. So the nasal passage, it via the pharynx, it here the trachea is there, and the upper part of the trachea, it is the larynx, which is nothing but the voice box. So this trachea, windpipe, it is divided into bronchi. These two, you can say bronchi, or single, you can say bronchus. Bronchi or bronchus. Bronchus is used for the singular term, like one pipe. So these two bronchi, they are divided here, and they just here, they are further divided into bronchioles, right? Bronchioles. And the terminal bronchioles. Terminal bronchioles. Bronchioles are what? They are the fine tubules, and the terminal bronchioles, they are having the bag-like structures. They are called as alveoli. Right? So these structures, these many structures, they are present in the respiratory system. Pharynx. Pharynx is what? The part of throat between the mouth and windpipe, it is called as pharynx. The part of the throat between the mouth and the windpipe, it is called as pharynx. and very short passage it is, nasopharynx. Now these are the structures, and when we talk about the nasal passage, here the fine hairs and the mucus is provided so that the filtration of the air takes place. Air gets filtered because the fine mucus and hairs which are present in the nasal passage, they just trap the dust particles and the air is filtered here. Now air gradually enters to the trachea, windpipe, and from here to this one, and here the air, it comes to the bronchioles, and when here it comes at the level of alveoli, actually the gaseous exchange takes place. So the point of consideration is that gaseous exchange, right, or the diffusion of O2 and CO2, it takes place at the level of alveoli. These are the two principal respiratory organs, paired structures like lungs, which are present in the thoracic cavity. Lungs, they are made up of millions of alveoli, right? You can see here this trachea, it is divided into bronchi. These terminal bronchioles are having the sac-like structures called alveoli, and they constitute the lung. Here this is right lung and this is left lung. So the paired structures which are called as lungs, they are the principal respiratory organs which are made up of alveoli, where the actual gaseous exchange takes place. And the point is that the question arises, why alveoli, they are there, like why millions of alveoli are there for the constitution of lungs? And the answer is just to enhance the surface area, because we know that for better absorption the good surface area is needed. So this is the reason alveoli are provided with, where alveoli, they are the region where the exchange of gases takes place, and they are provided because just to enhance the surface area. So when oxygen rich air comes from here, the dust particles trapped in the nasal passage, it comes to here and then here and then here, and comes at the level of alveoli, where the diffusion of the gases takes place. Oxygen come into the blood. When oxygen come into the blood, then what happened? It goes to the cells, and in the cells it gets utilized for the burning of the food. Energy extraction is there, energy is released, and in the same process the CO2 is produced. This CO2 by the blood itself come at the level of alveoli and again expelled out through the nose. So that is how the transport of gases takes place, and this is how the respiratory system, it gets worked. Now let us come to this point. I just want to show you how the gaseous exchange takes place. This is alveoli, right? Bag like structure, a sac like structures, millions of alveoli, they are present in the lungs. So actually very rich blood supply is there. We have already discussed that the respiratory structures should have good blood supply. Why? For the exchange of the gases. So here this is alveolar cavity and this is the blood capillary, right? Suppose the air comes inside, that is rich in oxygen. So here oxygen is there and it gets diffused out in the blood. Why? Because it moves from its higher concentration to lower concentration. So this is the blood capillary. It is provided with to each and every alveoli. Very good rich blood supply is there. So the oxygen diffuses in the blood like this. And same as for the CO2, when the CO2 it is released in the process of oxidation of food through the blood, it comes to the alveoli and diffused in the alveoli. The CO2 diffuses in the alveoli and gets expelled out through the nose. So that is how the exchange of gases takes place. And this is the experiment which shows that the CO2 is released in the respiration, and nothing complexity in this, like just the principle behind this experiment is that when the CO2 gets released, it makes the lime water milky. And the milkiness of the lime water, as we know that the CO2, it turns the lime water milky. So the milkiness of the lime water, it will show that the air which is expelled through the mouth, it is having the CO2 content more. That is why the lime water will turn the milky. The exhaled air, it is having more CO2 content in comparison to inhaled air. And this is the reason the lime water will turn the milky. So this is the experiment. General principle is following here, and here the respiration, it is almost discussed, right? Here we have seen the different respiratory structures as per the requirement of the organism, and here we have seen the movement of the rib cage, which resulted in the expansion and the contraction of the cavity inside the lungs, so that when the expansion takes place, air moves in, and when the contraction takes place, air moves out. And here the respiratory structures, as we have seen, the lungs, they are provided with the alveoli, and very important point is that the alveoli, they are the actual regions for the exchange of gases. And this is the enlarged view of an alveoli, where you can see that how the oxygen, it gets diffused. As you can see here, alveoli, it is provided with the blood capillary, and here the oxygen gets diffused in, and CO2 get diffused in the alveoli. Oxygen get diffused inside the blood in the blood capillary, and CO2 get diffused in the alveoli outside the blood capillary. So and we have also discussed the experiment which actually show that the CO2, it is the CO2 which is present in the exhaled air, and it is because of the CO2 the lime water will get turned milky. So these are the important topics for the respiration part. And if you like this video, just like, share and subscribe, and press the bell icon for the upcoming notifications. And one more point, you can comment your requirements as well. So till then, take care of yourself, and very goodbye.